This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
$20 million, $19 million, $6 million. These are all awards recovered for clients of Phillips Law Firm. To win big, you have to fight big. And Phillips Law has been fighting the too-big-to-fail insurance industry for decades. Not every case will have a multi-million dollar outcome, but Phillips Law will fight just as hard to recover the outcome you deserve. If you or a loved one has been injured in a car accident or on the job, call or click today at 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
Hey, this is BJ. Thanks for listening to our show's podcast. If you're a fan of all things geeky, you should check out my other podcast, BJ Shea's Geek Nation. We have new episodes every day, and you can check it out at bjgeeknation.com.
Your home is going into foreclosure, and you feel like a financial wreck. You don't know where to turn for accurate information. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne. Let's talk about some legal options. If we work quickly, we can propose a plan to save your home, modify the loan, or in many cases, even eliminate your second mortgage. The consultation is free. I've helped hundreds of people just like you make informed decisions about whether to save their home or exit it on a reasonable, organized timeline. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
Let's play Beat Migs.
It's time to play the game.
Yeah.
So everybody scream his name.
Beat Migs.
Don't be a loser.
To turn down for tequila.
What?
Tequila.
Oh, okay.
What?
Tequila on a Tuesday.
Tequila.
Okay, I'll do it.
Okay. Let's get to our contestant today. We got Michael in Port Orchard. Michael, are you there?
Yep.
Excellent. All right, Steve, get out of here.
Goodbye.
For those playing at home, Michael will have 60 seconds to answer 10 questions. Michael, you can pass all you want, but you will only get 3 guesses per question. You ready?
Yep.
If you were given a quarter, 1 cent, 2 dimes, and a nickel, how many cents would you have in total?
51 cents.
Yes. Whom did Gene Siskel share co-hosting duties with on At the Movies?
Oh.
Oh, that's going to be a tough one.
Pass.
Who succeeded Ronald Reagan as the 41st president?
Well,
George Bush.
Yes. What gas makes up approximately 74% of the sun's mass?
Nitrogen?
No.
Oxygen?
No.
Pass.
On a map, what state is directly above Pennsylvania?
New York.
Yes. In what decade was Eddie Van Halen born?
40.
No.
30.
No.
50.
Yes. What is the second most spoken language in the world?
Spanish.
Yes. Who is the tallest female member of the cast of Friends?
Pat.
What sports hall of fame is located in Cooperstown?
Baseball.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 correct.
All right then.
Yeah.
Okay, did he get the last one?
Yeah, he said it.
Oh, I didn't even hear it.
I heard it. I heard it.
I was wondering why you were cheering. Boy, I couldn't even hear that. All right, well, congratulations anyway.
Yeah,
that helps.
I have my headphones super loud when that happens too, so I can hear that because, I mean, the sounder happened right at that moment, but
yeah. He
got the correct answer.
Good job.
I bet Steve will get that one.
Look who it is.
Oh, hey, it's Steve.
Hi.
How you doing?
Super duper.
Are you ready?
All right.
If you were given a quarter, 1 cent, 2 dimes, and a nickel, how many cents would you have in total?
51 cents.
Yes. Whom did Gene Siskel share co-hosting duties with on At the Movies?
Jeez, man, that's an old question.
Yeah,
Roger Ebert.
Yes. Who succeeded Ronald Reagan as the 41st president?
Bush.
Yes.
George Bush.
What gas makes up approximately 74% of the sun's mass?
Methane.
No.
Butane.
No.
Air.
No.
Hydrogen.
No. Yeah. On a map, what state is directly above Pennsylvania?
Hmm. What state is above Pennsylvania? New Jersey.
No.
Massachusetts.
No.
New York.
Yes. In what decade was Eddie Van Halen born?
50s?
Yes. Nice. What is the second most spoken language in the world?
Spanish.
Yes. Who was the tall? Who is the tallest female member of the cast of Friends?
Phoebe.
No.
Lisa Kudrow.
Yes! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You win 7-6!
Yes!
Oh, yeah.
Yep, yep. You got the character first, but then you got the actress. Congratulations on your win.
I have a question, though.
Uh-oh.
Well, when it comes to presidents, sometimes you don't take Roosevelt as an answer, so what's the rule? Can we just say the last thing? Because we have two Bushes and two Roosevelts.
I'm just trying.
So when I'm
no,
playing,
you're right. You're absolutely right. Yeah, I just was like, I was just going to accept Bush on that one or George Bush as long as you.
And that doesn't work either.
Because, no, it doesn't because yeah. You. I mean, technically,
now you got to know his middle initial, isn't it? Is it George H. Bush?
Yes, but it's also George H. W. Bush. Like yeah. That's what they go by,
right?
So
I would say Junior. Let's just say Junior.
He's the older one.
No, older Bush.
No, but I mean when you're trying to George Bush is the regular
senior.
Yeah, George Senior, George Junior, I suppose.
But is he a junior?
Way. Well, I mean, which is
gotta be.
I mean,
does he
son.
Have to be?
I mean, yeah, you're yeah. a junior if you're the son.
But if he doesn't have the exact same name, does he have the exact same name?
I don't
George
know. If middle
Bush.
Names matter.
Yeah, middle names don't matter when you're talking about junior.
Yeah, I don't know if middle names matter with the designation.
I have no idea. That's why I'm asking. But yeah, I should actually do the differential because I do with Roosevelt. So you're not wrong, but both of them said Bush. So I was
just
like,
all right. Either way was fine. I just want to know the rules. So if I have to play Steve, I don't want to, you know.
I feel you.
I want to get it.
I understand.
I want to know
one.
The rules, man.
And then, yeah, you did figure out the only one that you didn't get correct that you got to was hydrogen. It is the one that makes up 74% of the sun's mass.
That's a lot of mass.
It is. But you still won, so congrats, Steve.
People have to play better. I need a song. Hey, there's a guy in Oklahoma. Now, look, a lot of us have a lot of time on our hands for whatever reason, if we're not working or whatever, that we can't go anywhere. So this guy decided last year, because of the pandemic, he was going to do something really cool. He spent 4 months turning his van into the mystery machine from Scooby-Doo.
Awesome.
He said he did this because he just wanted to make people smile, which it will. I mean, if you see this guy going by, you're going to go, hey, that's awesome. And he's now using it as a mobile vending machine with part of the proceeds going to charity.
You know, I think there's a mystery machine somewhere here in the Northwest. Okay, I thought I saw it on the road one time and it made my day.
Yeah, some people have seen it down in Tacoma and Lakewood as well. So I think it's kind of down around that area.
I like the idea this guy turned it into a business.
That's pretty cool. And he has a good, I mean, he's doing it for a good reason as well. It's nice he's making money for some charity.
Yeah.
I hope he offers Scooby snacks.
Then he might get arrested for drug deals.
Yeah, that's the thing. Because we all believe that Scooby Snacks were LSD or something.
Mystery Machine would be one that I would absolutely geek out. I remember when I went to a SummerSlam one of the times in Los Angeles, they had the Mystery Machine set up with like a couple people dressed as Scooby-Doo characters. I'm trying to find the picture. And it was like me and Munson both are just cheesing hard because we're in front of the Mystery Machine. Because you feel like you're in the cartoon for a second.
Yeah, it is pretty cool. And and really, when you think about it, it's not that difficult to recreate. But it still is pretty cool to be standing in front of it.
What would be even easier, though, is to recreate the A-Team van. If you're going to do it, it's just a red stripe.
Hell yeah. That
a black van with a red stripe.
Oh, what don't forget the spoiler on the top of it, too.
Oh, good point.
You need the spoiler. Okay, never mind. It's easier to do the Mystery Machine.
So if you're going
to
get a vehicle and turn it into what vehicle, you know, what like car, like what?
Oh, I want the 1960s Batmobile.
You want the Batmobile would be a little bit harder because you can't just find a car and then trick it out to look like the Batmobile.
Oh, I thought I was just get to do make-em-ups.
No, make-em-ups are fine.
Yeah. I don't know what I mean. What would be easy? A DeLorean maybe from Back to the Future?
Well, you'd have to get a DeLorean. Good luck with that.
See, Steve, I don't know. All the cool cars I like are not easy.
Yeah, I guess a van's the easiest. I mean, it's like, I'm sure you could find a van anywhere.
I mean, you could always do Herbie.
Herbie the Love Bug.
That one's
I've
good
seen
one.
That a bunch of times, and it makes me smile every time.
Yeah. That is a good one, yeah.
Better than putting eyelashes on your damn beetle.
Agreed.
Oh, those are adorable.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, if you're a 17-year-old girl.
Well.
Really?
Or a 69-year-old lady.
Nice.
Yeah. There we go.
So instead, I would go with the, where the... Crap, where the hell the times go?
I don't know what happened, man. I was just looking right at it.
I've seen the A-Team van on First and Pine. One person
said. There's an A-Team van that we have around here.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. All right. So we got people that, you know what? They're making it happen.
Another Mystery Machine is also in Monroe.
All right. I want to see a Batmobile then. Somebody make a Batmobile.
And a lot of people have texted this one. That's what I was trying to find. The Jurassic Park Jeep. I've seen that around a lot.
Oh, I forgot about that. Yeah.
It's pretty awesome when you're driving around like on a freeway and you look over and there's a Jurassic Park Jeep and you're like, where are we going? Are we running or are we heading towards something?
That's nice. That's pretty sweet. So there's a guy that made a post on Twitter that ended up trending, and he asked this. He said, what movie makes you cry no matter how many times you've seen it.
Ooh.
And he's got four that do it for him. We'll see if you guys hit the four. You know, one of the four, anyway.
Oh, man, that's a good question.
You know, it's funny.
I try not to watch sad
a lot of these.
I stay away from sad movies for a reason.
A lot of these are, you know, make sense. But it's really interesting. There's a couple of Marvel movies in here that I don't understand. That, you know, I think
maybe, Daredevil. Daredevil made me cry.
Oh, that made you cry because it was so bad?
Yeah.
I'm with you on that.
Actually, did make me cry in the theaters and had nothing to do with sadness. I was just really tired that day. And I was doing a billion things. I went to the screening for Daredevil, and I was there. And as I'm watching it, I got like, you know, you get overtired, and sometimes you just get a little teary-eyed. And I sniffled, too, at the same time.
Wow.
And so I did that, and all of a sudden, like, some teariness is going over. And the person sitting next to me going, looks at me just like with disgust, like, are you crying? Like, no. Like, it looked like I was crying. And
it sounded
Daredevil.
Like you were crying, too.
Right. I was, like, sniffling. Last time I cried in the theater, though, was Marley and Me.
Oh, oh well, like,
that's you saw that in the theater?
That's understandable.
That's a terrible idea, Rev.
Yeah.
And I was mental. I prepped myself. You will not cry. I know that this is going to be a sad story. It involves a dog. I'm going to cry. I really like hyped myself up to like be ready and not cry. And it just took one person sniffling in that theater. And it was just like it was like a domino effect. Once that person started sniffling and crying, another person started, and everybody then started sniffling and crying.
Oh, damn.
And it was just the most pathetic thing in the world to be in a theater full of people, just all of us are crying.
People say Apollo 13.
I don't even remember.
Why?
Well, because they almost didn't get home.
Yeah, but they do
but
get
they
home.
Do. Then there's triumphant tears.
Yeah, I mean, really.
I get teary-eyed still when I watch Miracle and they won the gold and they're all standing there on the podium.
Yeah, and fair. I got teary-eyed.
Spoiler
when,
alert.
Yeah, I got teary-eyed with, you know, Captain America and during Avengers Endgame.
Yeah, Avengers Endgame is on here. Oh, yeah, on your left. How do you not cry at that?
Oh, no, I was thinking more along the lines of Mjolnir.
Oh, that too.
Basically, spoiler alert, when the big reveal happens and everyone's coming back, from that point to the end of the movie, I did not stop crying. And yeah. I have not been able to watch it again because I know it would just be tears.
See, when I went into the Avengers, I knew the big spoiler alert thanks to one of our texters about Iron Man.
Yeah.
And so I went into it fully prepared for that. So I didn't start crying in that part. But like everyone around me was. And my wife started tearing up. She's not even a comic book fan. Like she started tearing up because it's a pretty powerful moment. I just look at her and go, you're such a wimp. And she's like, how are you not crying and I'm crying? I'm like, well, I already knew what was happening. She's like, you didn't tell me? I'm like, no, I didn't want to spoil that for you, but I knew.
Yeah, I didn't want to spoil you crying while I wasn't.
I was like, in my head, I was like, this might be the one time where I get to have fun with it. Because she always makes fun of me whenever I get teary-eyed. She's like, are you crying? I'm like, no. Stop looking at me. You won't know.
But there's you know what? You don't have to be a comic book fan to cry at that. They set that up pretty well. If you remember in Avengers Endgame.
Great.
With his kid,
yep.
You know, and everything he had to lose. So they set that up nicely. Like, you know, here's the guy that dies, the guy that really had the best life, you know, without doing anything.
Mm-hmm.
So they, you know, there was a nice message there for anybody that wanted a message.
I'm trying to think of the last one. Like, I mean, Peanut Butter Falcon. That got me a little teary-eyed.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
That was a really cool movie, though.
Big Fish, The Green Mile, and Saving Private Ryan are in the top list for everybody.
The Green Mile, yeah.
Yeah. But here's this one. Thor and Thor the Dark World, people were crying over.
It's because they were watching them.
Yeah. I mean, I don't remember anything about Thor that I wanted to cry over, and The Dark World is I barely remember that, but I know it wasn't good for
what
me.
What about The Marine 3? Is that on there?
Is that the one with The Miz?
Yeah, I think so.
And why did I know that?
The Marine 3 has been called.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW. Hey, you got something to say? They're wild, rapid, and on the loose. This is Listeners on the Loose.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. It's Listeners on the Loose. You pick the topic. You guide the show at 206-421-ROCK. You can also text us at 77999. Listeners on the Loose, this is it, man. This is where you get to voice your opinion. But remember, Steve has a rule.
It's a simple rule, BJ. That's to show some energy and bring it. Otherwise, you're going to be gonged and we're going to have to say goodbye to you.
Goodbye, old friend.
206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999.
Somebody wanted to know, what is the proper etiquette for coming and saying hello to you guys at the gym? From Chad. Say hi.
You mean to us?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, first they got to find you at the gym, right, Pete?
Yeah, there's no proper etiquette. That's because I'm not there.
Dude, I had one time someone came up to me and he just had his phone out and goes, "Is this you?" And I was like, "Oh man, is this some kind of like repo situation?" I look at the what he had up, it was my Facebook page. And I'm like, "Yeah, it's me." He's like, "I didn't know if it was you or not. I thought it'd be weird." I'm like, "No." Like I know some people get weird about people talking to them at the gym. I think it's totally cool.
Yeah, I feel like if somebody just goes, "Is this you?" and shows a picture of you, that it is weird. At that point, he could have just said, "Hey, are you that guy, Steve Miggs?"
I mean, because everyone does it differently, BJ.
Yeah, everybody says. Some people show you a phone and go, "I am Satan."
No, as long as I'm not like laying on a bench and you don't like hover over my head saying, "Are you Steve?" It's like your boys are dangling over me. Other than that,
wow. Oh, that's the only way to introduce yourself to Steve. Actually, is you got to do the dangler.
At least wait till I'm done grunting.
Okay, fair enough.
Whoa.
Yeah. Is there anybody else? Is he going to run into maybe Joey D's? No. But anyone
Danny,
else? At
Danny's
the gym?
A 24-hour fitness. Aren't you listening to him on the radio talking about that?
I don't know. Danny's. All I know is he's in 24-hour quarantine. It seems like every time I know Danny,
more like 24-day quarantine.
Right.
Yeah. Okay, so it's Danny, it's you, it's Joey D's. Otherwise, I don't know if Vicky or Rev goes to the gym. I know I don't.
No, now that bans have been lifted, I'm actually thinking of joining one right by my house. But I don't mind it when people come up at all. Although I am very impressed that whenever I'm wearing a mask and someone does recognize me from the show, it's just like, how do you know just from my eyes? That is very impressive.
There are people that can do that too, and I can't. And I'm talking to people, I don't even know who they are. And then they're like, "How do you, don't recognize me?" And I'm like, "Oh, it's you."
Dude, I sometimes don't even notice, like, family members. Like, I'm the worst with that. But then there'll be someone that'll, like, drive on the freeway, and all of a sudden you hear a honk, and I'm like, "How did you spot?" Like, that's, like, that's, like, extra level of, like, alertness.
You have a unique look, Daughtry.
That I do. I mean, they're like, "Who's this guy that looks like Shrek driving?" Disney's not here. Why is he driving around? DreamWorks is not here.
Yeah, you know what?
Universal Studios is not here.
You're really a big fan of what you are, actually.
What do you want from me?
I don't expect a lot anymore, to be honest with you. I have lowered the...
Has there ever been a weird place that you've been recognized?
A weird place?
Because I'll give you, for instance, one
I know
time.
I know your weird place. I hope you tell that story.
Which one do you think it is?
Well, I'm going to wait and see because I don't want to ruin... You might even have a weirder place.
The weirdest place I've ever been recognized was at the fertility clinic.
That's the one I remember.
Yeah. Wow. Back when we were going through the IUIs and I had to go and drop off a sample. And there was that moment. And it happened twice. One time, the person said, "What's up?" And it was awkward.
"What's up" is not the thing you say at a fertility clinic.
Right. Like, I don't want to shake your hand. Like, kept the couch warm for you, buddy. Have
you
fun in the collection
up.
Room. Right. You know what I'm doing here.
Yeah.
But one time, somebody sent me a message on Facebook and just said, "Hey, I saw you at the fertility doctor. I didn't think you wanted to be bothered, so I didn't say hi." And I was like, you know,
nice.
In any other situation, I would have not had a problem with that. But I was, like, probably one step into the collection room when this person saw me, so... Like, and the collection room is where you go and take care of business, if you didn't know.
Oh, is that what that is? The collection room?
They call it the collection room.
Oh, really? That's an interesting name for what they're collecting. Yeah, that makes sense.
Well, they're collecting something.
Yeah, they are. They
gotta
surely
collect
are.
Them all.
Yeah. It's life's game of Monopoly.
Yeah. Or Pokemon.
That too.
Yeah.
Not poking anything.
You're surely poking no one. Actually, it's poking no one. Oh, I can't top that. I don't know if there's any place at all that would be more uncomfortable, you know, than maybe a doctor's office or something like that. But you have a beat with that fertility clinic because you know what's happening and you know what they're doing. You know what you're doing. I mean, yeah, that's a bit embarrassing.
I might tie with you.
Oh,
really?
At a swingers party.
Okay, for a different reason, absolutely, that is awkward.
Because I'm just chatting with people. Like, I found a group of people that were in my age group, because it's like 90% of it, they're, you know, older couples. And we were all having a blast talking about, you know, Captain America, the movies that were just coming out. And then one of them was like, "Oh, no, I know where you work." And I'm just like, yeah, nice to meet you.
Were you, now I have no idea how this works. It's not a nudist colony. At the time when this person met you that knew you, were you in any state of undress?
No.
Oh, well, that's
luckily
at, least,
at that point, no, not yet.
Yeah, at least that's not too awkward, but still, everybody, it's like Steve's situation. They know why you're there.
Right. But I think Steve, I don't think I beat Steve, but I feel like we probably tie.
No, Steve beat Steve, especially there.
Multiple times. But, I mean, at least yours is like in a fun situation. Right. You know, it's a nice icebreaker, quite possibly.
Well, then it's also that, like, well, now I have to be on my best behavior. What if this, like, whatever I do here gets back to, you know, anybody? So it's not, I don't have that, you know, veil of anonymity.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
I agree. I mean, I wonder how they do that because, you're going to these parties, and I mean, of course, unless they really have that cone of silence and they go, what happens here in here stays in here. But I'd be with you, Vicky. I'd be like, man, now I don't feel like I don't feel so comfortable. Somebody knows me that I don't know.
Yeah. They're on to me.
As it were.
My most awkward meetup was definitely when I got pulled over by the cops. And I was going to get a speeding ticket, and the guy takes out my license, and he looks at me and he goes, oh, you work on the radio, huh? And I freaked out because, you know, in my head, every time you get pulled over and they recognize you, it's like there's more of a reason to give you a ticket than less. But luckily, I got off and didn't get a speeding ticket.
Nice. Well, you have it on your license that says I work on the radio? Where do I click that?
Dude, and my name's different because I have a longer name that's not Joey. So I was freaking out on how he even knew who I was because at the time, it wasn't like I was online or anything.
Was this the Mercer Island?
Yep.
Well, I mean, your dad's in cahoots with them. That's probably
that's what it is.
Cahoots.
Oh, yeah.
They drop off Oreo cookies for him and everything.
Yeah.
Oh, thank God, too, because I was going like 25 over the speed limit.
What?
Yeah, I was going 47 in a 20 or something like that.
Oh, I heard about that, son. I mean, just they were like, they were the one, they came to me and said, hey, you got to tell your kid to slow down.
It was a really dumb reason. There was a big hill, and I thought, now this looks like a challenge. So I just let go of the brake and flew down.
Sheesh, man.
Yeah, that's my son. 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999.
Oh, man. This is an interesting one, BJ. Okay. After 3 years of will he or won't he, my boyfriend finally proposed. And he did it on Valentine's Day. And I absolutely love the ring. Here's the problem. I posted the picture of the ring on Facebook, and his ex, we're both still on good terms and we get along and we're friends. Well, she private messaged me saying that looks exactly like the ring that he gave her because apparently she still has that ring as well. So she wants to know, is that weird that he bought the identical same ring for me that he bought for his ex as well?
Well, that just ruins everything. Thank you, ex.
Yeah,
why would you do that?
To be honest, when I first saw this, I thought like he just like ended the relationship, got that ring, and then used the ring, and then just like basically regifted the ring for the new.
Which might be
worse than this.
Yeah, I agree. If he regifted it, yeah, it's like, dude, you have a chance of being found out. But if he just, you know, bought the same exact ring, it's weird. No doubt about it, but I can see guys doing that. It's like, look, I thought that was a pretty ring before and somebody else really liked it, so why wouldn't I get the same ring since it's already been verified as a really cool ring? I mean, I can see a guy's brain thinking like that.
Right, like I have certain types of clothes that I always get because I know how they fit and how they look, and I'm happy with them. Yeah, that is a guy thing. It's like, this ring's pretty. It worked last time. Might as well get it again.
Yeah,
briefly last time.
I will say this, and I would like to say this to the entire female population, or at least the female population that cares about this kind of stuff, you know, because I remember my prom was ruined because some girl had the same dress as my girlfriend, and I'm like, you know what, seriously, you gotta be kidding me on this, who cares?
So this was a different prom, not the one with your cousin. That one
okay,
wasn't
listen,
ruined, right?
I never went to the prom with my cousin, never had a fight with a snowman,
swear.
And you guys are indeed effers.
We will one day find the audio of you talking it might not have been your prom, maybe it was her prom, but you went to a prom with your cousin.
You're never going to find audio because I've only been to one prom, my own. Even my cousin wouldn't take me to her prom.
Well, I don't know what to tell you. Was your first cousin mad at your second cousin because they wore the same dress at the same prom?
Okay,
I don't know.
I am so done with you. Go find the audio. You'll never find it because you're losing your mind.
I know it exists somewhere.
And the rest of the show is pranking me through you, and really, we're getting both trolled.
But we've had texters saying that they remember hearing you say that as well.
And the texters, of course, wouldn't be trolling you, would they? Or me?
No, they're all on the up and up.
Totally. Yeah, they sure are. Every single one of them.
Every one of them.
I think that you have to just, look, your man loves you. This is the guy you want to be with. And some douche who really shouldn't have eaten Facebooked you, but she's jealous and pissed because that's the only reason to do this, because she knows, wait till I tell her. I mean, who cares? You're the one rejected. I'd be like, yeah, you know what? The ring works on me and doesn't fit on you, cinder bitcha.
I like the one texter that says, hey, that ex is being a drama queen. She's way out of line. Block her ass. Yeah, like, what's the point? It's not like he used the exact same ring. And even then, like, stay out of that person's business. What are you accomplishing by saying that looks exactly like mine? Even if you're friends, I would. That's like something you don't need to share.
Exactly. If that was my kid that did that, if Sarah did that or Joe did that, I'd step in as a parent and go, well, you're a douche. Thanks for being a douche kid. Why do you got to go ruin some other people's life? Why don't you go out and have a good life yourself?
Someone says, for all you know, like he didn't even realize it was the same ring. That could be.
Yeah.
Well, I mean,
he's like, oh, dude, that rings pretty. I've done that before.
How random is that if you're that clueless and you buy the same exact thing and don't even know? That's pretty amazing.
I'm so stupid. I bought the same Pearl Jam vinyl twice. I mean, like, their second record, not realizing I already owned it.
There have been CDs that I have bought. I have three copies of one random obscure CD because I thought I lost it. Like, right. I get this.
I mean,
okay,
look,
I can't talk to either one of you two right now.
A little bit cheaper really. Than yes. a Pearl Jam record is an engagement ring, but I can understand this.
Okay. You know, I remember one time when I went out and bought a record, not like a $35, $40,000 thing, and it's the same.
I'd make fun of you guys, but I bought the same comic book two or three times.
Okay. Well, all right. How
Just
much was
like
that
an
worth?
Engagement ring.
Like 10 bucks.
Okay. You know what? Seriously, you geniuses with your small purchases, will you please?
All right. Maybe, well. We got text about you in the prom thing.
Okay, listen, stop perpetuating this. It never happened.
All right, well, maybe we were wrong. You could be right, BJ. This texter brings up a very good point. It wasn't prom. It was a Sadie Hawkins dance, and she asked him.
Okay, first of all, no, I don't.
How does the texter just make that up?
Because they're trolling you and me, you what? Pearl Jam double copy moron, you.
Someone said, yeah, I totally remember BJ talking about him going with his cousin. He even talked about the type of flowers that he got her. Roses.
That person's insane. I never went to the prom with my cousin. I've only been to one prom, and that was mine.
Well, could it be Sadie Hawkins?
No, there was no Sadie Hawkins. Nobody asked me to anything, Steve. My dating life was horrible. Not even my own cousin would ask me.
Man.
All right, well, if we had the audio, I'd love to know where it came from. Because I'm losing my mind.
It came from your mouth, man.
All right, dude, I have no memory of this. If it happened in my life, I can't believe I've forgotten, and I have no memory of even saying it on the radio.
One texter has a good point about the lady that just texted. What's the problem? Says, you're missing the point, though. Like, why does the ex still have the ring, and why hasn't she given it back? Bitch.
Do they have to give it back?
Yeah, see, that's a good question, Rev. I think it's like, isn't it like a rule that you don't give back the engagement ring? It's like hers.
I thought that if you had a daughter in those instances, if you wanted to keep it for them, but I feel like that ring is jinxed at that point.
Yeah, you got to go pawn it. You just have to. Why would you keep it?
Yeah, I don't understand. When are you going to use that? Like maybe for Halloween, you're pretending to be married or something? I don't know, but I don't understand that. I would want to get rid of that memory like instantly. It's just like there's no use for that ring. So you might as well get something out of it, return it or sell
it
or something.
Yeah, you get some cash for it. Get something.
Right. I do love that people are now texting about their absent-minded things. See, we're not alone there, Vicky or myself or Rev. Someone said, I bought my daughter the exact same birthday card 2 years in a row, LOL.
All right, yeah, see?
I've done that for Christmas. I got the same card for Christmas for my wife twice. It's a penguin.
Yeah.
And each time I think it's cute, so I get it, and then I forgot that I got it the year before.
I don't know how that's possible since I feel like they really rotate those cards out. I can't believe they keep the same ones on the shelf that you could buy it again.
Well,
that's,
but was
that's
a,
amazing.
That, was it papyrus or papyrus or whatever
the
hell it is?
Papyrus?
Yeah,
they've got like a certain thing, and every year they have the penguin with the little snowman's hat or the little Christmas hat.
Oh, gotcha.
Santa hat, that's what I'm trying to say.
Well, I will give you credit, Steve. Those cards are not cheap.
And
you're a good husband if you're getting papyrus.
Oh, dude, I'm balling when it comes to
When
it comes to cards, money's no object, BJ.
Do you even take the little gold circle with the hummingbird and put it on the front of the envelope, you know, so that way you look like a fancy guy?
Oh, yeah. Of course. I spare no expense.
They don't give you
that gold circle for nothing.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
$20 million, $19 million, $6 million. These are all awards recovered for clients of Phillips Law Firm. To win big, you have to fight big. And Phillips Law has been fighting the too-big-to-fail insurance industry for decades. Not every case will have a multimillion-dollar outcome, but Phillips Law will fight just as hard to recover the outcome you deserve. If you or a loved one has been injured in a car accident or on the job, call or click today at 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.
New on Curiosity Stream. With superior armies comes superior weapons. How has innovation mechanized the battlefield? From bullets to battleships and everything in between. It's machinery of warfare. Plus, from the gross to the gourmet. See how that in-flight meal lands on your tray table. on secrets of your airline food. It's all on CuriosityStream. Annual plans are $20, just $1.67 a month. Visit CuriosityStream.com.
The world needed a safer trampoline. Dr. Keith Alexander, inventor of the spring-free trampoline, wanted to bring the joy of trampolining to his daughter. His wife said they were too dangerous, so he invented his own. Spring Free Trampoline is the world's safest trampoline, with no springs or hard edges. Now, parents can have peace of mind that their kids are outside jumping safely. To learn more, visit springfreetrampoline.com.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle. It's listeners on the loose. You pick the topic. You guide the show at 206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999. Let's go to Mitchell in Gig Harbor. Mitchell, you are on The Rock.
Hey.
Good morning, Mitchell. Welcome to the show.
I just wanted to test base you real fast. I tried my own pickup line a couple months ago in a Starbucks.
All right.
That I would share.
Okay.
So, cute girl working the counter there. I paused, pulled my phone out, flipped the camera on, and walked up to her. I was like, hey, I need your help to come up with a line real fast. I know this really cute girl. I'm super nervous, and I'm trying to get her number. I got a picture of her. Take a look. Tell me what you think I should say. And I just handed it to her with the front-facing camera on, so I just showed her face, essentially. And she paused for a moment, smiled, looked down, looked up at me, and said, that's really cute, but I'm already taken. And I was like, well, you know, you got to shoot your shot, right?
Well, Wayne Gretzky said you miss 100% of the shots you don't take, after all.
That's right.
That's clever. I mean, I never heard of that one before. How would you take that, Vicky? And maybe Sarah, too.
I'm an idiot, so I would be like, your camera's on, dude.
Your phone's broken.
I mean, like, you accidentally turn your camera on. I can't see your picture. Like, I would totally be that idiot. Like, not getting it.
Oh,
I just know myself.
Then there's that awkward moment where he has to now explain this cheesy pickup line.
And then it's like, Sarah. Oh.
Yeah, I'd like to know what Sarah would do, because I feel like it's a little creepy, the fact that, wait, you took my picture, I didn't know about it?
Well, he didn't take the picture. If he took the picture, I think that's weird. But he just handed it to her in selfie mode. So she's looking at the video.
Okay.
I hope he didn't take the picture. I don't think you should take pictures of people without
that. Yeah, I see what you mean. That's a little better. But Sarah, so the idea is this, Sarah. If somebody basically did a little cute thing where they said, hey, I want you to look at this cute girl. I don't know what to say to her. What should I say? But then he's got it in selfie mode, and it's really, he shows you the phone, and you're the cute girl. All right, there you go.
Nice.
That's kind of cute. Yeah, I like that. I would be confused, probably.
Just like Vicky. Yeah.
Wait, I don't think the picture's right. That's me. But yeah, no, I like that one.
All right, since you guys are in the room, let me ask you guys this question, because someone just texted. The question's for Vicky and Sarah. What's the oddest thing that anyone has ever asked you in your DMs? For instance, my girlfriend just got offered $3,000 from a creep to have her spit cheese on a man's foot.
What?
Can that person email me, please?
Yeah, it doesn't have to be his foot, right? Just any man's foot.
I assume. I don't know. I mean, yeah, if it's on that actual guy's foot, I'd be like, babe, I don't know. But if he could volunteer his foot, I'd be like, you want to make $3,000? Go get that cheddar.
I'll spit cheese on anyone's foot for $3,000.
Yeah, I'm all for that.
So it's Vicky B at KISW.com. Tell him, just forward that email to me, please and thank you. The weirdest thing I think I've ever gotten in my DMs is, will you change my diaper?
Oh,
I'm sorry, Vicky. I meant that for Kathy. Sorry, my
awkward.
Wife.
Awkward.
Yeah, sorry.
He kind of looked like you. Very creepy, but it was not you.
Okay.
But,
what about you, Sarah?
I have a guy who keeps sliding in my Instagram who's willing to pay me $500 to cuddle him. And my boyfriend thought that was very strange. And so then he said $500 for an hour foot massage he would give me.
He wanted to give you an hour foot massage.
Yeah, and he would pay me $500.
Yeah, see, some people got a foot fetish, so he definitely just wants to touch them
feet. Which, I'm cool, because I love foot massages. And for some reason, J-Rubs thinks that's less weird than the cuddling.
Oh, well, I mean, you're touching less of the body. You know, I guess the feet, some people don't feel the feet are that big of a deal. But cuddling means he's getting all up next to your business.
I mean, he's just, you know, holding me tightly.
Yeah, he's all up next to your business.
There I can just take a nap or watch a show for an hour or
something.
Yeah,
but if he's the big spoon, you know, he might be happy to be cuddling with you. Even if he has his clothes on, you still have to deal with that awkwardness.
And if you're the big spoon, all your business is up against him.
I mean, that's That's fine, though. I think I'd rather be the big spoon in that situation.
You're in control.
Yeah. Yeah.
Or
yeah.
as much control as possible.
I would just hold him instead.
Yeah, you know, I think I'm going to leave the spoon and the cheese spitting. I might be done.
Yeah, but $500? It's an easy $500 to make, I feel like.
There's a dude that's like hit up like some like random wrestlers on the indie scene, and you'll get a DM, and it's just like he'll somehow try and find a creative way to get pictures of your feet. So it's like, hey, do you wear big feet? Like, what size shoes? You know, it'll like be like the most awkward things. Like, I remember one time I got one of those messages. I just instantly just ignored it. But some of my buddies will like keep the conversation going and they'll send the screenshots. And
oh,
it's
that's
like,
awesome.
He doesn't want to pay for them, but he tries in like the least, I don't know, tactful way to get you to just like voluntarily show him pictures of your feet.
Excuse me, sir. Do you have feet?
Right. I hear wrestlers have damaged feet. Can you prove that?
Oh, jeez.
206-421-ROCK. Text us at 77999. It's Listeners on the Loose. You pick the topic. You guide the show.
Last week, we were talking about people getting busted for things that they do in the ring camps because some guy ended up dropping off some stuff and urinating on it, and that's how he got busted. Well, our buddy Photog Jim, he just sent us a text about that, saying about 6 months apart, our ring cam caught the same Amazon driver tossing our package from several feet away. The second time, he had shampoo and conditioner in it, and one bottle broke. We reported him. They responded by saying, he's being retrained.
He's being retrained. Man, I would think that, you know, everybody knows you don't throw packages, right? I mean, how do you... That's got to be like, no, you're fired. If you don't know not to throw these packages, come on. Your job is to deliver packages, not throw them.
Yeah, I'd almost like, if I wanted to get fired, that's what I would do. I'm like, wait a second, I can't get fired even for the things I'm trying to get fired for.
Yeah, I'm telling you, man. So far I haven't had any bad experiences with the packages I've gotten from any delivery service. I don't know if it's Amazon. I don't know who's doing it because I get a lot of my stuff. So far I've been lucky, apparently. But, man.
Imagine you see that on your ring cam, people just chucking your boxes onto your porch. I'd be so pissed.
Maybe I don't want to get a ring cam after all.
Oh, yeah, you do.
If this was going on before and I was happily ignorant about it, if it's going on now, people urinate. I mean, I don't want to know what people are really doing to my stuff. Man.
Yeah, but it's something exciting when like the ring thing goes off and you can see what's happening like in real time, especially when you're not home.
See, that's your new TV show you're getting.
It's like
to watch.
The Truman Show for me.
Yeah. 206-421-ROCK, Texas at 77999, Listeners on the Loose.
Plus, you can leave treats for your... My wife and I both have the app on our phone, so whenever I check and open up the door, you know, it'll instantly set off an alert, so I'll make a funny face, or I'll pull my pants down, or... That one, I have to probably pump the brakes on that if we have neighbors, but before that, I would, like, moon the camera.
Oh, so you know that she's going to be able to see someone's opening the door, so you give her a little video treat of you... Pulling your pants down.
Right. And also we pay so that you can like go back and watch the archived footage.
Oh, wow. That's like what you pay to watch a wrestling show. So you're basically watching TV on your ring cam.
No, it's cheaper, BJ. It's like $3 a month or something.
Oh, is it
like
really?
That. Yeah,
all
it's
right.
a lot cheaper.
Well, you know, I mean, yeah,
I get my money's worth.
That's like $36 though for the whole year. So really, Rev, I don't know.
Actually, it's $30 for the whole year if you pay up front.
That's
look at this.
Mm-hmm. Yep. That's all what
right
I did.
Then. Look at your ring cam watchers. Unbelievable. Yeah, you probably should stop that, Steve.
We were talking about listening to music of a band that you're going to go see in concert on the same day, and I was wondering if that was weird or not. And you guys all agreed that it's not, but one texter says, why would you listen to the band you're going to see on the way there or on the way back? That's insane. That's like making dinner before you go out to a restaurant.
What?
I do that too if my wife didn't frown upon it.
That's like making dinner before you go. You know you can listen to stuff. It's not like you have a reservoir that gets filled of listening.
It's like pre-drinking at your house. You know.
I can't get fat for listening to Pearl Jam all the time.
Right.
It's also not like pre-drinking from your house because you then can still get drunk. But you never like you can't stop. Like it doesn't like your ears shut down going, all right, you listen to too much Pearl Jam. You're going to miss these songs. I mean, I don't understand that relate at all. That text, I don't know. Is that what you were saying, Vicky, or are you actually disagreeing?
Well, I'm saying that like it, you can enjoy it at all times, before, during, and after.
Oh, then you do agree. Yes, yes. I'm with you on that. Yeah, drinking you can do. Yes. I mean, yeah, I mean, that's... Hey, everybody's got their own thing, man.
Yeah.
I don't understand it, though. I would fight with this guy. If we were at a party, there would be a big argument with me and this texter. And that's usually why I was never invited to parties, because somebody would say something like that, and I'd be like, what? Because I recently had a fight with somebody over a game we played. He played it once, and he decided to analyze the game and said, yeah, this is a really bad part of the game. And I'm saying, Well, I played this game multiple times. You've just played it for the first time. It's not a bad part. You just don't know what you're doing. You need to really figure out what you're doing. And he insisted, oh, no, I know exactly what I'm doing. I'm like, I'm just like, how do you? And then when you talk to a person and go, well, you understand A, B, and C, they go, well, you understand it's my first time playing it. I go, then why are you giving me a critique as an expert if you're a first? Oh, it was a, see, you can't talk to me.
Did you challenge him to a match?
I played him in the game and beat his ass.
Oh, that's why he's bitching.
Yeah, that's what it was.
If he beat you, he probably loved the game.
Oh, yeah, believe me, that's how I am.
That's how I am, too. Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Games are awesome if you win at them.
Totally. Oh, yeah, there are some games I go, this is trash, I never want to play it again. And it's like the number one game on a site. And I'm like, well, I didn't win. I got my butt kicked, so.
Today's podcast was brought to you by Travis Gagne, bankruptcy attorney. He's here right now and has agreed to answer more of your questions about bankruptcy. Here's another question from a listener. I'm getting my wages garnished. Can bankruptcy help with that?
Absolutely. One of the big reasons people file bankruptcy is because they have a judgment or a lawsuit against them, or their wages are getting garnished, and so they can't pay their other regular ongoing bills. People sometimes think that you can't file bankruptcy once they have a judgment against them or once a garnishment has started, and that's not true. Filing bankruptcy will immediately stop any garnishment that you have going, except for child support, and stop your creditors from continuing on with garnishments of your bank accounts, your wages, and in most cases will discharge that liability through the bankruptcy process. And we can file a bankruptcy case for you usually the day you come in.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at choosetherightchapter.com. That's choosetherightchapter.com. Thanks for listening.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
New on Curiosity Stream. Are we close to building machines that are almost human? And can new technology give us superpowers? Find out on Super Sapiens. And in 1919, a British composer wrote the longest and most complex symphony in history. Conductors tried to perform it, but failed, declaring it cursed. Now a group of musicians will attempt the impossible, if they dare, on Curse of a Gothic Symphony. Watch now on Curiosity Stream. Annual plans are $20, just $1.67 a month. Visit CuriosityStream.com.
$20 million, $19 million, $6 million. These are all awards recovered for clients of Phillips Law Firm. To win big, you have to fight big. And Phillips Law has been fighting the too-big-to-fail insurance industry for decades. Not every case will have a multi-million dollar outcome, but Phillips Law will fight just as hard to recover the outcome you deserve. If you or a loved one has been injured in a car accident or on the job, call or click today at 1-800-JUSTICE or visit justiceforyou.com.